Hello, this is your girl Wilma, and we're going to be studying the King James Version Bible, and it's the Holy Bible, okay? And everything in it is the rules that we have to obey, and no matter what we go through in our face in this word, we got to live up to it, okay? It's our roadmap of a life that we can inherit the kingdom of God if we follow it. It's the rules and regulations of the road of life of Jesus Christ. And it's in the Old Bible and New. So we're going to read in a bunch of scriptures today. So I hope you got a pad and a pencil and you write some of these scriptures down, okay? Okay, and what we're going to be studying on today is man shall not lay with man, and that's what we're going to be studying about. So, and it's in the Old Bible and New Bible, so that's what we're going to be studying. You can turn to Leviticus. It's in the Old Bible. It's in the first of the Bibles here, first part of the Bible, Leviticus chapter 18 verse 22, and we're going to be studying now on a whole Bible. All in the front Bible and in the back of the Bible. So we're going to be studying on these, okay? Now you get your pencils and papers ready, and we are going to be turning over to 18 verse 22. And it says, thou shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind. It is abomination. And what that means is that men lay with men in their own kind, and women lay with men in their own kind, and seeing that, they said it was an abomination. Now we're going to turn to in the New Bible, we're going to be turning into 1 Corinthians. Now write this down, or just open your Bible and you can find it. And 1 Corinthians, okay? And okay, you turned over to 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9 and 10. See, it's in the New Bible too. So that's, we live on the New and the Old, because the Old is ammunition. And it says in 9 and 10, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind. There it goes again. In verse 10 it says, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. Will not inherit the kingdom of God. Okay. Now, the next scripture, we're going to turn to Romans chapter 1, verse 26 and 28. 1 chapter 1, 26, and we'll go to 28. And it says, for this cause God gave them up unto vile affections, for even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature. And that means that it is against nature of man and of women and women sleeping and touching each other. Okay, now let's go to verse 27. And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burned it in their lust one toward another, men with men, working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error was meet. See there? Verse 28. And even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not covenant. Convenient, I mean. He gave you over to the reprobate mind. That means that he just let you go wild in your own conscience, in your own ways. He just let you go wild because you just didn't want to acknowledge God's law and his rules. Okay, that was Romans. Now we're going to turn back to 1 Corinthians again. Let's go back to Corinthians again. And let's see what it says. Corinthians chapter 6 and 9. Chapter 6, verse 9. Says, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind. I know we just read that, but I thought it would be good to reread it again. Okay, let's go, let's see, Romans chapter 1, verse 26. Did we just read that one? And it says, for this cause God gave them up unto vile affections, for even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature. He keeps going back to the same scriptures. In Exodus chapter 22 and verse 19, it says, whoever lies with an animal even shall be put to death. God don't even want us to be doing these nasty things, okay? Now, Leviticus chapter 18 is in verse 1 through 30 is where God gave Moses the law, and the rules wants us to abide by, okay? And let's see, 1 verse 29. Okay, go to Romans chapter 1, verse 29 and 32. Being filled with all unrighteousness, fornication, wickedness, covetousness, maliceness, full of envy, murderer, debate, deceit, malignity, whispers, backbiters, haters of God, despiteful, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedience to parents, without understanding, covenant breakers, without natural affection, implacable, unmerciful, who knowing the judgment of God. See, you even know the judgment of God. They even know the judgment of God that does such things. They know it, but they don't even care about where their soul is going. That they which commit such things are worthy of death. It says we're worthy of death if we commit such things. Not only do the same, but have pleasure in them that do them. Now you see that? Even if we have pleasure in them that do such things. Oh my goodness. I'm getting down to the nitty gritty now. I think I'll stop right there. I might go to Timothy. And I did have a scripture in Timothy that I might wanted to say. Verse 10. Timothy. Verse 10. It says, for whoremongers, for them that defile themselves with mankind, for men stealers, for liars, for perjured persons, and if there be any other thing that is contrary to the sound doctrine. You see that? Mankind, it just goes right back to it again, all the way to the end of the Bible. All the way to the end of the Bible. It's talking about it. It's talking about it. I had to bring it out because God showed me in visions last night. In a vision, not a dream, but a vision. about these two girls that wanted to go and get married. God showed me in that vision, and he said in that vision, this girl wanted to get married in Vegas. And the one girl, there was a big long line, you know, to the church in Vegas, and they wanted a Elvis impersonator to marry them, like a preacher, but he has dressed up like Elvis. And in that vision there, God showed me that that the one girl was wanted to sit down because she was so tired. And she wanted to sit down, so she saw a tree, and she said, "I don't want to go over here and sit at this tree." She told the other girl to go on and stand in line. So that girl went up there to the door and says, "When you see me to the door and go in, you jump up and come too, because I don't want to leave my spot in line to come and get you." So she, after she got up to the door and she went in, she was waving to the girl under the tree to come on. The girl under the tree had a vision from God also. in my vision, God gave her the vision too, and he told her that it's abomination to him and unclean to marry this girl, and the two girls marry each other. So and God opened up her eyes and opened up her heart and mind and saved her under that tree. So she went in there and she told the other girl that God wanted her to leave her and be separated from her, but be friends, but they cannot go together and do the things that married people would do, or man and woman would do together. So she told, and the girls just ran out of that church and flew down the street, and the girl that got saved ran after her and explained it to her about all that that God had told her and how she got saved, and she ministered to her. So she ministered to that girl, but she left heartbroken. Her eyes and heart was not open. She left heartbroken. So, and that being said, God had showed me in that vision how it is wrong. And I know that some people is going to get offended by this, and I'm very sorry if you do. And even if my child, I know I got a child that's like that, and it's going to hurt his feelings and break his heart. And it's breaking my heart too, because I have to tell my child that it's wrong. And he loved the other person very dearly, and it's going to hurt him. And I'm sorry if this video is going to break everybody's heart and cause you to be angry at me and cause you to be mad at me. But God told me I had to minister about it, because I am a minister. And I cannot let you go on living into this kind of way and me not tell you. And your blood will be up on my hands. So I don't want your blood up on my hands. I want to have a backbone and explain to you what God wanted me to tell you and everyone else that is living like this. I hope you don't get offended, you know, and be hurt. And I hope God opens up your heart and open up your mind and your soul to this. And as you learn and be taught of the Bible, you're not being getting mad at me. You're getting mad at God and his judgments. And I'm very sorry on this behalf, because I just want everybody to understand the road that you take is the master that you serve is the one that you're going to be living with on the hereafter. So, and that being said, thank you for stopping by my channel, and I hope that the Lord opens your eyes and blesses you to understand. Thank you for stopping by my channel.